Renoise and Redux have, respectively, a strong or singular focus on samples. And so, right from the start, you've been able to modulate fundamental aspects of a waveform as it is being generated. This concept was pioneered by early hardware synthesizers. So some of what we cover in this video may be familiar to you, but nevertheless, there are certain aspects particular to Renoise and Redux. Adding modulation to samples greatly expands the possibilities of their sound beyond the original audio. The modulation is created by inserting devices into an interactive chain, constructing an envelope. Separate envelopes are used to modulate three basic domains: volume, panning, and pitch. There's also an optional filter, whose three domains depend on the type of filter selected. When notes are played, the original sample is modulated polyphonically, meaning that each generated waveform is being shaped by its own individual playthrough of the envelope. So, the same note can be made to sound completely different every time it is played. A modulation set is a specific collection of the six domains and the envelopes contained within. Any number of sets can be created, and each instrument has its own unique set list. The instrument samples can be individually assigned to any one of its sets, allowing different samples to be affected by modulation in different ways. Multiple samples can be assigned to the same set, so all of those samples will be affected by any changes made to that set. The lists can be rearranged by click-dragging the sets around. A set can be duplicated, either with the right-click menu, or by holding Ctrl, a command on the Mac, and click-dragging. Double-clicking on a set's name allows you to rename it. Individual sets can be loaded and saved as presets using the drop-down menu located at the top right corner. They can also be imported and exported for sharing. Note that when loading or importing, this will overwrite the currently selected set. So, if that's unwanted, then you should first insert a new blank set. Each domain has an input slider, which is the starting value of the envelope. The volume and filter domains have a value range from 0 to 1, while the panning and pitch domains are initially centered at 0, but range from -1 to 1. This represents panning left and right, and pitching up or down. The pitch domain has an extra control at the top left of the envelope panel, which adjusts the pitch range of the modulation. The default is one octave, and this can be changed down to a single semitone or up to 96, which is 8 octaves. The envelope is constructed by inserting modulation devices, creating an interactive chain. To add a device from the list, either double-click on it, or drag and drop it into the chain. Positioned before each device are 4 buttons, which change how the envelope will be altered by the output value of that device. Add, subtract, multiply, and divide. The operand and fader are easy to set up and understand, while the other devices require far more explanation, and that's why they are featured in their own separate videos. For this video though, here's a brief description of what they do. Building complex multi-stage envelopes normally requires chaining together multiple devices. However, the AHDSR and envelope are both capable of doing this entirely on their own. The key tracking device changes its output depending on the note that is played, while the velocity tracking device does so according to the note's velocity. The LFO oscillates the selected shape at a low frequency. And finally, with the stepper, every time a note is played, the cursor moves forward in its envelope, changing the output value. Each modulation device has a standard set of buttons to perform common functions, which you should be familiar with from the beginner's tutorial. However, there are a couple of extra ones for you to make use of. The first is this positive-negative button that toggles the output between bipolar, both positive and negative values, and unipolar, only positive values. The second button is only present on devices that have parameters dealing with time. So that's the AHDSR, envelope, fader, and LFO. Disabling this button will change the values from strictly time-based to beat-synced. Incredibly useful if you want modulations to synchronize with the music, and they keep pace with any BPM changes. Thank you. right-clicking on a device, we'll select it and open a context menu. The options are self-explanatory, but of particular note is the ability to append. This will insert any copied device or device chain at the end of the current chain, instead of merely overwriting it. As with most things in Renoise, the modulation section provides you with a strict framework, but lots of modular parts. So you can get creative with constructing what you want to hear by connecting different things together. And let's finish up by looking at a few examples. Most parameters of the modulation devices are available as targets when using macros. So check that video out for full details, as well as the accompanying video on crafting a free-running LFO. It shows how macros can be used to run modulation in a completely different way. Normally, when you assign a sample to a modulation set, you're stuck with the choice you've made. But this video provides you with a method to get around that limitation. And it also does so for a similar limitation in the effects section. And finally, if you need some direct inspiration, check out the instruments that come bundled with Renoise or Redux, as well as the presets in the menu we looked at before. And for those of you who are registered users, if you haven't already, check out the backstage area for extra downloadable content. The Jorek pack in particular has a lot of great modulation presets for you to try out.